If you're just getting started in cybersecurity, there's two certifications that you will hear about a lot. The first one is obviously CompTIA Security Plus, and the second one is Google's Cybersecurity Professional Certification offered by Coursera. Now, honestly, I don't know where the hype from the Google cert came from. I'm not sure if it's because Coursera pushed it pretty hard or if the Google name is attached to it. Either way, their marketing worked, and it's a popular entry-level cert. So today we'll talk about and answer the question, is the cert worth getting? No. No, it's not. I mean, it depends, but I'll touch on that at the end of the video. So I don't think the cert is necessarily worth getting. I do think the course is worth it.
Hear me out.
So back in 2022, I fell victim to the hype and signed up for Coursera Plus just to see if I could knock out this cert. There was a special going on where you could sign up for the 14-day free trial and the course was included. At the time, there was this cheat code in their business strategy. You see, if you took that course within 14-day time period, you would get the cert and essentially get it for free, right? And you know me, I like free. Free 99, let's go. So I speed ran that thing and managed to obtain the cert for free. I was able to do this at the time because I had already graduated with a bachelor's degree in cybersecurity and I was passively studying for the Security Plus, so I pretty much knew the basics. But when I was running through this course, I was kind of blown away with the coursework that Google had offered. It was unlike anything I had taken at the time because it offered something I hadn't seen before. It was a pretty hands-on approach to learning. Now I'm sure there's courses out there for other certs that are robust, but to be honest, they may cost like thousands of dollars. I don't know about you, but my attention span is so short that sometimes I cannot hang with the YouTube cybersecurity playlists. Anyways, the Google course walks you through the basics, right? Starting with what cybersecurity is, the CIA triad, vulnerabilities, exploits, how attacks work, the kinds of tools that professionals use every day, pretty much the stuff you can learn anywhere. But I was surprised, not just by the videos and the slides, which they kind of give you like those like HR onboarding vibes, but they're entertaining enough just to kind of hold your attention. And they also sprinkle in those like real world people testimonies, but they do it in a way that doesn't kind of make it feel like they were held at hostage. You know what I mean? But beyond the videos and slides, you actually get hands-on practice with things like the Linux command line, SQL queries, using SIEM tools for threat protection, GRC stuff, and even some Python for automating tasks. And at the end of each module, it kind of has you create a project, which in hindsight, I should have taken advantage of because those projects you can throw on your portfolio. I mean, they're specifically created so that you can throw them in your portfolio. And I think there's even a section where you build a resume with those projects. It's a really good course, but to be honest with you, that's pretty much where it ends. Because nowadays, they patch the method I used. I mean, you can theoretically finish the course within 14 days, but you need to be a paid member for Coursera Plus in order to actually get the certification. And for $50 a month, you have to ask yourself if it's better to save that money towards a quote-unquote real cert that holds value from a resume perspective. Now, I will give Coursera and Google some credit, not just because one day I would love to shill their product, but the course itself is good, and it may further spark your interest in cybersecurity and help you pick a path. Plus, everything you do, you can throw in your portfolio. And that's what's important. With other certs, especially like Security Plus, I've seen people take the test and then complain about how they can't find a job, really. And they ask themselves, okay, I've completed this cert, what's next? And so that's why I really wish this cert held more value on a resume, because there's just so much value in the course. Is it worth $50? Maybe. I mean, it really just kind of depends on how you frame it. My last video, which if you haven't seen, please go check it out. I mentioned that there's really only two certs that you need if you're a beginner, with that being Security Plus and like a networking cert like Network Plus or CCNA. And while I stand by those things, to be honest with you, they're expensive. Let's run the numbers. Security Plus is $404. Network Plus is like $369, and the CCNA is $300. I mean, that's a lot of money. And I mentioned that I studied for Security Plus in 2022, but I didn't take the test until like 2 years later. And that's because at the time, that's when I could afford it. And to be honest with you, I used my school email to get like half off. So I think it only came out to like $264 for me. Plus, my job reimbursed me for it, so it was free 99. Basically, what I'm saying is a lot of people can't afford that, but they may be able to afford $50. So I will say you have to analyze your situation and kind of choose from there. I mean, at the end of the day, it does feel nice to have something in your cert section in your resume. So before I go off on a tangent and take this video to a place where just basically losing sight of the topic, I will say that, like I said, I think they do offer like a 7-day or 14-day free trial. Try the course out. If you like it and you can complete it within 14 days, do so. And if you decide that $50 just is something that you can spare, go ahead and honestly get the certification. The test isn't hard. Unfortunately, it's not proctored, so that'll give you some peace of mind. Not saying it's open book, but it isn't proctored, so be with that information with what you want. But yeah, so get it if you can, but you can honestly skip it if you are trying to get something that holds value on a resume and HR. So that's the end of the video topic, but I just want to, and I know I beat this idea in like a dead horse, and I still think it might be a hot take for some people, but especially for beginners, I honestly don't think that you need certifications. I mean, for instance, you can game your resume in a way in which you can add certain certifications and kind of like put them in parentheses, like in progress, right? I'm not saying to lie, but there are ways to frame it to where you may pass the resumes like ATS, right? Their automated tracking system. And then you can speak your heart out in the interviews and go from there. And when you get a job, you can go back and knock out those certs. Sorry, I don't know what that noise was, but I'm keeping it in because it sounds like maybe what I was saying was true. Anyways, if you're determined enough, you'll find ways to land a job with a solid resume and projects. Like, don't fall into marketing. Don't listen to these YouTubers or Redditors who try to tell you your path. Everyone's situation is different, and there's not one way to the finish line. So all in all, I don't know if it's worth it because I don't know you or your situation. It just really depends. So all I can say is try the free trial and see for yourself. If you like it, take it. If you don't, move on. So if you made it this far in the video, thank you. Hashtag certified cert chasers in the comments down below. I realize when I'm making these videos that I make a lot of cert videos. So moving forward, I might take a step back from that. I want to make more engaging content that's going to teach you cybersecurity in like unique ways, as well as tangible things you can throw on your resume and get a job. I'm going to try to be a little bit more consistent with these videos because I haven't thus far. So yeah, with that being said, you might see like a couple more like clickbaity videos. I'm definitely going to do like a roadmap, and then I have a review coming about an awesome course that I found from a YouTuber. So those are going to be down the pipeline. I have to make videos that are at least somewhat decent for the algorithm. But I will always make them with your best interest in mind. So with that being said, please subscribe, like it if you like it, dislike it if you didn't like it. And what are your thoughts on the cert? You know, do you have it? Has it helped you? Has it done nothing? Let me know in the comments down below, and have a great day.